become the world champion, or he must unmask and reveal his identity. And here we go. But Triple H has never faced a challenger that has the incentive that Kane has here tonight.
No doubt about that.
And no!
Kane aiming for the game, but got the referee. The long blow. The pedigree. The hook of the leg. Hebner's going to count. It's going to be over. It's going to be no! Kane lives.
What?
Can you feel it?
I do feel it.
Can you sense it? Here it comes. The And Randy Ortega Kane face first down. The referee didn't see Orton's interference. Another pedigree.
He's out on his back
after Randy Orton's interference. No, kick out.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
The game wins it.
Kane, you know the stipulations. Now take that mask off.
What's Kane going to do?
He's going to unmask. That's what he's going to do. That's what he better do.
Interested in taking on Randy Orton here tonight, one-on-one, Eric Bischoff, the co-general manager,
who is really acting as the general manager tonight, was able to acquiesce. Look at these men like holding on to that collar and elbow tight, like two pit bulldogs rolling to the outside. And it has been a wild ride tonight, all thanks to Eric Bischoff, a new women's champion, and Gail Kim, that Seven Diva Battle Royal. We saw Christian and Booker T fight to a draw. The general manager's decision draw as Dreamer takes a header into the steel steps.
And don't forget, we saw, well, you know, in the past we saw Stacy Keebler dump Test. Tonight we saw Test dump Stacy.
That was absolutely hideous. I'm just appalled at the two athletes, the caliber of athletes that Test and Jericho are, would even take that match. And I am appalled and sick that Eric Bischoff would make that match happen. Look at Randy Orton, assaulting one of the toughest men to ever step inside the ropes in Tommy Dreamer.
And you were appalled at Rico, weren't you? Rico and Jackie Gator.
I didn't know quite what to think about Rico.
Oh, you were appalled.
And I still don't know. I was confused. And dazed. And then King, what about Bischoff putting a gun to Kane's head? If Kane doesn't come out here and show his face tonight, Bischoff's going to fire Kane here tonight.
Well, you can't blame Bischoff. Kane's face got big ratings last week. We want him again tonight. That's compelling TV. That could be another defining moment in the career and legacy of Eric Bischoff.
Well, we've had several defining moments in Randy Orton, the third generation star.
I don't know if I want to see Kane's face, though. He is wicked ugly.
You know, it was...
That's a busted grill if I've ever seen
it. It was disturbing. That's the way I could put it. Disturbing. Randy Orton, hard Irish whip, and got a hook of the leg and a near fall. Orton really sent Dreamer to that turnbuckle with a great deal of
momentum. You think Kane will come out here, or will he get fired?
Anymore, I don't know what to think about this now.
Look out.
Great dropkick. Randy Orton, textbook dropkick. Hooking the rear leg there, Tommy Dreamer.
Textbook dropkick. That's a thing of beauty, you got to admit. This kid is so impressive.
They're going to knock him? Textbook is a bad thing?
You know, it's not glowing praises.
Well, Orton measuring Dreamer. Oh. Dreamer! By the corner of his eye, sees the young man is still in his early 20s. Wow. And Orton getting hung up there on the top rope. Big Charles Robinson keeping an eye on this thing as Tommy Dreamer. Right there, Dreamer starting to build some momentum here. All in the... for the spirit of Mick Foley, who was busted wide open last week at the hands of Randy Orton.
You think Mick Foley's watching tonight? His eyes stitched together.
I'm sure that he is. We wish him a very speedy recovery. And man, what a fine buster slam that was, and a near fall.
That would have made Mick Foley happy.
Tommy Dreamer, a real, another all those hardcore guys from ECW, and that's where he got to know Mick Foley so well. Tommy Dreamer now, look at the that leg drop for the elbow. Wasn't quite sure, but he didn't get nothing but canvas. Gives Randy Orton some second life here. And Orton now, again, that front face lock, countered by Dreamer. And Dreamer into a DDT.
Oh, no.
Dreamer in the DDT, going for a quick cover.
Hold it, hold it. And puts outside the ring. And calls for a break.
And the dirtiest player in the game, the legendary player.
Hey, Tommy Dreamer, stay in the ring. You don't want to make him mad. Wait!
And it ain't made of chocolate, Nate.
Get away, Nate.
You don't want to eat that thing.
Run away.
We're backing away, and rightfully so for Dreamer.
Yeah.
And Dreamer looking to go downtown. And there's Randy Orton with the RKO.
He's going to go downtown if that's where the hospital is.
Orton with the RKO on the victory.
Here's your winner, Randy Orton.
Come on. The match is over.
Never threaten Ric Flair with a kendo stick.
Why don't you find Flair, disqualify him, or reverse the decision?
Hey, wait a minute. Oh, man.
And look at this, Orton. What Dreamer in a figure four helpless.
He's getting ready
to Orton with a knockout shot.
He's getting ready for the All-Star game. I think he can hit a home run and believe it, that kendo stick ain't caught.
Randy Orton should be above tactics like that. You can almost see the arrogance and confidence oozing out of his pores. Well, Orton is successful tonight in Revolution.
I think there's something oozing out of Tommy Dreamer.
Well,
but it ain't confidence.
Will Triple H be successful tonight when he meets RVD for the world title? That's my question.